could have been a beauty queen. Blonde hair, 5'5", with some big blue eyes. Always has a coffee in her hand every time she clocks in for her shift on a Friday night. She waits tables, Waffle House, syrup is maple. The hours ain't bad and the income is stable. She knows it could be worse, at least she's healthy and able. She's trying to pay all her bills, she's still late on the cable. She feels stuck here, she's had a rough go, it's been a tough year. Has mixed emotions about this town, cause she grew up here. So many good memories, but such bad luck here. Dealing with so much stuff here. She lost her daddy to cancer, her brother to pills. Only been 6 months, still doesn't feel real. Sometimes it'll hit her and she's suddenly ill. Goes in the back room and throws up, then cleans up the spill. Then she shakes it off and walks back out. What can I get y'all? Then she writes that down. Refills the water cups and then turns around. And that smile changes back to a frown.
Hey, hey, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be alright. Hey, hey, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be just fine.
She clocks out 10:03 and counts her tips. 75 bucks, not bad for a shift. She fills her tank up with gas, buys a Coke and chips, then drives cross town to pick up both her kids. See, Annie is 9, Jackson is 7. She was a senior in high school when she got pregnant. They were a mistake and a gift straight from heaven. It's tough as a single mom, but she's learned her lesson. She's got a new man, he treats her real good, he does construction. She's taking it slow, it's been a few months, and she can maybe see it really turning into something. But her heart's been broken too many times, no need to rush it. She says eat your dinner, ice cream, then bed. Alarm clock goes off at 6 a.m. She gets the kids dressed for school and she's off again. Jenny's clocking in her second job at the day's end. She cleans the rooms, takes out trash, changes sheets, sweeps the floors, folds the mats, then leaves the three to pick up Annie and Jack and drop them off with the sitters working back to back. Jenny says, I'll be back, mommy's gonna meet her friends. She's in the church parking lot at 8 p.m. She has a smoke outside with her sponsor, Kim. They talk about life and finding peace within. Then they sit down and listen to everybody's stories. She would never say it, but she finds it kind of boring. In the back of her mind, she thinks, this ain't really for me. She don't like to open up, but Kim says it is important. Hi, my name is Jenny, I'm an addict. It's been 6 months to the very day it happened. December 14th, I witnessed something tragic. I've been sober 2 months now and haven't relapsed yet. My daddy was a good man, he worked in the mines. Spent his whole life underground, never got a chance to shine. Mixed that black lung with the Marlboro lights, and he was diagnosed with cancer at the age of 59. Slowly but surely, he wilted away. Chemo took everything he had, but he would never break. Cracking jokes at the end, telling us to be brave. He was the kindest man I've ever known, I miss him every day. My brother Chris had just got back from overseas. He comes home to see daddy and all those IVs. It was too much to bear, and I was starting to see my little brother lose himself more piece by piece. Coke turn to pills, pills turn to H. All that stuff these days is fentanyl laced. One bad batch, one time, that's all it takes. I know Chris didn't want to die and it was a mistake. We laid him to rest up there next to daddy, up there on the hill near a big willow tree. I put fresh flowers on their grave from time to time, but the weight of all of this is weighing down on me. My drinking got so bad, I was a terrible mom. On benders for weeks and I could barely keep a job. I'm turning it around, I got sober, found God. I'm just blessed to be alive, but some days are so hard. I'm sorry for rambling, thanks for listening. Everybody applauds as Jenny sits back down. She feels the weight of the world lifted off of her shoulders, but all she really wants to do is cry right now. She hugs Kim, smokes again, then heads back home. Annie and Jack try to wait up, but they just fell asleep. They were up late watching YouTube on my phone. The sitter says as she grabs her coat to leave, Jenny checks on the kids, turns out the lights, brushes her teeth, and slowly climbs into bed. She lies awake for hours just thinking about life, wondering if she'll ever feel normal again.
Hey, hey, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be alright. Hey, hey, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be just fine.